All right, we are back here. It is time to show me the money for the division conference championship round. Joining me today on the podcast, the host of the Sharp Chatter podcast, one of our regulars in the NFL playoff picks, Joe D'Aloisio, is here. Joe, how are you?
I am doing well, Mike. Show me the money. Love the sign. Love the setup you got going on. Thanks for having me, as always.
Not a problem. And I have to say, I think you're the only guys who has been on all 3 years of the playoff picks. So this is a tradition we have to keep going.
Well, damn it. I'm honored and I'm glad to be here. And I will preface this. I am doing very, very, very well this offseason, this postseason, excuse me, with the picks. So hopefully it continues here on the podcast.
Hopefully it does. And I will say we have to do a little bit of housekeeping before we start this. We did do the over-under bets at the beginning of the season. I had a solid year. We touched on this a little bit in week 12. You want to go back to our podcast and listen to the full details. I'm not going to waste everybody's time here, but I went 3-3 on those. So I did a good, pretty good run.
Okay.
You did not do as well. You had an 0-5-1 showing here. So not great for you.
Yeah, definitely not great. Definitely not great.
It's probably your thought when you had some of those picks going on.
Yeah. Yeah. I definitely regret. I think my worst one may have been the Cowboys. The Cowboys Super Bowl pick actually may have been my worst one. But yeah, rough year in the over-unders. But better news, the Green Bay Packers are playing in their second consecutive NFC Championship game.
Yes, they are. And I will mention that there were stakes in this. Like next time in New Rochelle, I'll be getting a sandwich with Joe from the Avenue Deli. But we'll talk about his Packers. They make Joe happy. So,
hey, you better not get an extra large sandwich.
you know, I'm not going to do that to you.
Of course. Of course. Yeah. But yes, next time you are in the New Rochelle area, a sandwich on me. Well deserved. Congrats. You won. I lost.
All right. And let's get to the Packers-Rams. That's the first game of the weekend on Saturday. And I have to say, like, this one was not even close in the beginning. I mean, last week I thought the Packers would win this going away. What'd you think?
Okay, so going into it, I thought the game would be much closer. All right? I thought spread-wise, I loved the points. I said take the Rams. I thought it would be, anywhere between a 3-4-point game. I thought it would be close only because of how great the Rams defense has been all season long. But man, when push comes to shove, the number one offense certainly embarrassed the number one defense. I also thought throughout the game that Green Bay was one play away the entire game from opening it up. And it finally happened in the fourth quarter with Alan Lazard, but it was just Rodgers missing on a few or a wide receiver dropping on a pass. It was like they were there. They were right there the entire time, but just couldn't get over the hump. And they got fortunate. I mean, I know you said it wasn't a close game, but they're up one possession. A.J. Dillon fumbles the ball, and luckily it falls right into Rodgers' lap. If the Rams recover there, man, I think we got a nail biter going to the end.
Yeah, they do. And you mentioned that Alan Lazard throw in the fourth quarter there. I mean, I saw that live. I'm like, oh my goodness, this is probably one of the greatest throws I've ever seen. It was like literally a laser beam right into his outstretched hands, easily runs into the end zone. I think it's probably, again, shows you why Rodgers is the MVP this year.
I don't think I could repeat the words that came out of my mouth out of excitement on the podcast when that play happened. But like I mentioned, right, there were several moments in that game where the Packers almost connected, right? You could go back to the first drive where Rodgers hits MVS. The ball's a little high. He's wide open, though. Should have been easy 7 instead of 3. All right. He also missed MVS on what could have been a 90-yard touchdown. Had a miss to Alan Lazard. In the third, I don't know if it was the third quarter, but there was one play where Davante Adams had a double move, got behind the corner. Okay. Rodgers sees him wide open, throws it as soon as he can. Davante Adams has to make the adjustment. If he leads them, that's another big play. So, yeah, this team won by 14 points, right? Packers won by 14. It looks like they left a lot still on the board, even with scoring 30-plus once again.
Yeah, they did. And this week they have the Buccaneers coming to town for the NFC Championship game. Pretty cold in Green Bay, maybe snowy. But one thing I do think about, people do forget, these teams played in week 6. Tampa Bay won 38-10. Does that concern you at all heading into this game?
I don't think that concerns me one bit. I know a lot of people are saying, well, just like you said, does that concern you? You go back to last season, Matt LaFleur losing to the 49ers in the regular season and then getting embarrassed again in the NFC Championship game. Could that story repeat itself? I think this year it's a lot different. This offense is kind of want to say unstoppable right now. They have been all season long. The team that you saw earlier in the year that lost to the Buccaneers, that's not the same Packers team, and that's certainly not the same Bucs team. I think we're in for a treat, and the fans get what they've finally been wanting. Brady versus Rodgers in the playoff, winner, Super Bowl bound. I mean, come on. You can't say we haven't been cheated, that we didn't get to see a Packers Super Bowl against the Patriots, Brady, Rodgers.
Yeah, it might be the first and only time we get it, because who knows, these two teams will be back in the exact same spot next year. But what do you think of the keys to this game for the Packers? What do they have to do to win this game?
All right, well, keys to victory in terms of beating the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, I think first and foremost, you need to continue to protect Aaron Rodgers and give him time to throw the ball. This offensive line for the Green Bay Packers was arguably one of the biggest question marks entering into the season, right? They have shown up and played so well all season long despite injuries, latest being David Bakhtiari. All right, they this past week against the Rams, zero sacks. Rodgers was hit once. You give an MVP quarterback that much time to throw the ball, oh, you bet you're behind. He's going to find an open wide receiver or do something. All right, so I think protecting Rodgers is pretty key. In that first matchup, Tampa Bay was able to get after him, right? They were able to get after him and force turnovers, right? When the Green Bay Packers play a perfect game and do not turn the ball over, they are 11-0 this season. All right, on the flip side, defensively, get after Brady. It's kind of like a similar game plan that you had against Goff. Go man to man, force the quarterback to make a play. Now, granted, Tom Brady will make a play. He will make a few plays. I'm not comparing Tom Brady and Jared Goff by all means. But what I am saying is Brady will not escape the pocket the same way Goff wouldn't escape the pocket. They don't have that in that game. If the pressure is there, Brady is going to fall down and they take the sack. Take advantage of those opportunities.
Yeah, they do. We'll see what happens in that game this weekend. Let's talk about the picks. It's the reason why you're here. Alex Fasano, our good friend, was here last week for Teen Challenge. We had a little therapy session about his Steelers loss, and then we went opposite on all four picks, so probably we each went 2-2.
Okay, not bad. If you really want to know, I went 3-0 last week. I don't pick the Packers game,
yeah,
but 3-0.
Yeah, so Alex's wins last week, he had the Bills laying the points. He had the Buccaneers getting the points on Sunday night. So those were the two you got right. I took your Packers laying the 7 points. They took me out there, and I took the 10 with the Browns. I got lucky there when Mahomes went out. I think if he stays that game, I'm not covering it.
Yeah, I actually took the points as well with the Browns, and you're spot on. If Mahomes stays in, they're not keeping up. It was kind of blessing in disguise right there. And, hey, anything is possible.
Yeah, anything is possible. So on the year, Teen Challengers, 29-31-1. Charlie Borg's kind of put the challenge under 500 in the playoffs, going 1-5 in the wild card weekend. So
that's brutal.
Yeah. So the 3-7 in the playoffs. I'm 36-25 on the year, 6-4 in the playoffs. So postseason's still tight.
Postseason's still tight, but you only have 3 more total games.
Yeah, I do. So this week's going to be interesting here. We have 2 games to go. We're going to do the picks for both games. We're going to start out with the NFC Championship game on Fox on Sunday, 3:05. Your Packers are laying 3 points at home against the Buccaneers. What are you doing?
I'm taking the Packers. -3. I love it. I usually don't. I don't like, and I'm not saying this because I'm a Packers fan. But again, I think this is a completely different game that we saw earlier in the season. And quite frankly, if the number one defense – in the NFL couldn't slow down Aaron Rodgers and that offense, I don't see Tom Brady and their defense slowing down Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah, that's a good point. I think this number is tough for me. I feel like this is a 3-point game either direction. I think this is going to be very tight down the stretch, whoever has the ball last wins kind of deal. When it was at 3.5, I was going to take Tampa Bay. I was going to take the points there, but at 3, I think I'll go with you. I'm going to take the Packers here, lay the points at home. I think they're a more complete team. I think the Bucs have flaws. They took advantage of a Saints team last week that just couldn't throw the ball down the field. They took Kamara out of the game. You can't take really anything away from the Packers. Aaron Rodgers still beat you. So I like the Packers here. I'm going to lay the 3 points there, and I think we agree on that one.
Absolutely, we do.
All right, next up, the AFC Championship game, 6:40 on CBS. Bills at the Chiefs. Chiefs laying 3. The big unknown here is Patrick Mahomes going to play. As of recording, we don't know if it's a clear protocol yet. That's why the number's so low, in my opinion. Joe, what are you doing here?
See, that's the tricky thing, because as of recording, that number's so low, it kind of makes you want to jump on the Chiefs. Yeah. Just because if Patrick Mahomes gets clear and he's good to go, that number gets up to probably 6, yeah. Right? What do you think? 5.5, 6?
Sounds about right.
That range. With that being said, though, I'm taking the Bills outright money line. All right. I know it's shocking. I know you're surprised, but the uncertainty with Patrick Mahomes is huge to me. I know it seems and appears like he's going to be all right. It's going to be healthy, but the Bills have something magical going on right now. And I love their style of play on both sides of the field. I think Josh Allen has been tremendous this season. And I haven't been sold with the Kansas City Chiefs since the end of the regular season. Yeah, they ended up winning. But still they haven't won in convincing fashion. Not that matters, right? A win is a win. But I just think Patrick Mahomes' injury, before the injury, all the rest that he had and how he wasn't playing at the same caliber that we're used to him seeing him play at, I really think the Bills pull off the upset and win this one.
All right, I'm going to go against you. I'm going to take the bait. I'm going to take the 3 with the Chiefs, because I feel like there's enough optimism coming out in Kansas City. Mahomes is going to play. I'll buy it. Even if he doesn't, though, we saw that Andy Reid is going to be aggressive. He's going to run a very strong game plan with Chad Henne, and they have so much talent on offense. And the thing we forget about Kansas City is their defense is still very, very good. And Buffalo does not have a running game right now. Zach Moss is out. They were passing almost exclusively against the Ravens last week. I don't think that will work in Kansas City. I think the Chiefs will find a way to win, even if Mahomes can't go. But so I will lay the points with the Chiefs here. Lay the 3.
So we're locked in with these points, or are we getting a little leeway at the end of the week if this line jumps?
Well, I think we're gonna lock it here. I think we should lock it in here. I think it's not fair to the audience, because we're not gonna be able to know that we didn't change this.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, because I'm not gonna drop another podcast before this releases.
For the record, Bill's money line.
Yeah, I do it a weekly gambling post for fan side. Bill's money line is one of the bets I have on the line here, because number is good, and the off chance he doesn't play, that's a good line to take.
Oh, without a doubt. Without a doubt. I think it could happen.
Yeah, so to reset the picks here for the week, NFC Championship game, Buccaneers and Packers. Packers laying 3. Joe and I are both taking Green Bay laying the points. In the AFC title game, Bills, Chiefs. Chiefs laying 3 right now, number contingent on Patrick Mahomes' availability. I am laying the points to the Chiefs. Joe is taking them with the Bills. He strongly advises you take the Bills with the money line this week. Those are your picks for championship weekend, and it feels weird to only do 2 picks total.
It feels so weird that we're in championship weekend. Like, granted, I'm a Packers fan. I love the fact that my team is still playing in it, but I also hate the fact that we have 2 weeks of football left, essentially.
Yeah.
I can't get into basketball yet, I can't get into hockey yet. College basketball is a mess. I'm going to miss the NFL.
Yeah, we got
over. I miss it.
We got this Sunday. Then we got a Sunday with nothing, not even the Pro Bowl because of COVID. And then we have the Super Bowl in 2 weeks. So that's
truthfully, the Pro Bowl could just disappear anyway. I wasn't going to watch it.
I never
do. I think it's terrible. It's not even entertaining, slightly entertaining. So they actually are making out somewhat well that they don't have to worry about the Pro Bowl this year.
Yeah, there's no football next week, but we are not going without showing the money next week. Our Kevin Walsh is coming back here from sports. We're going to talk about all the different ways you can bet the big game. We're going to talk about the spread, the money line, the over-under, the props, all that good stuff with Kevin next week.
Are you a heads-tails prop bet guy? Are you color of the Gatorade prop bet guy? What do you like to dabble in?
I like the prop. I love the heads tails. It's so fun. It's so easy. I like the color of the Gatorade because it's so random. I like those parlays where you do the other sports involved, where it's like number of 3-pointers James Harden hits for the Nets plus like how many passing touchdowns the Chiefs have or something like that. That's fun.
Hey, you if you don't have a dog in the race, you could certainly have a lot of fun placing a few shekels on these prop bets.
Yeah, plus, like, I do like the ones that are not sports related in terms of, like, oh, what song is the Weeknd going to play first? Or, like, is Joe Biden going to tweet during the game or whatever, something like that. Those are fun, too.
The length of the national anthem, another classic.
Yeah. I like those. I do like also diving into the player-specific ones on the team. I remember last year I had a prop about the punter for the Niners, and that ended up working out for me.
There you go. Hopefully the luck continues this year, Mike.
Yeah, hopefully so. Joe, thanks for all the time. I really appreciate it. Before I let you go, I can be able to follow you on social media and keep up with the Sharp Cheddar podcast.
All right. So give me a follow on Twitter at Joe double underscore DALOISIO. Don't forget the double underscore.
Do not. You won't find them otherwise.
You won't find me. Yeah. And just search Sharp Cheddar podcast on pretty much any podcast platform, Apple, Spotify, Stitcher, SoundCloud, Google Play, Amazon, all those good ones. We are there. We already have our latest episode recapping the divisional round win against the Rams. And later in the week, depending on when you listen to this podcast, we will have a preview episode previewing the NFC Championship game against the Buccaneers.
Yeah, those are some good episodes, Emily. I saw you had a friend of the podcast, Dan Mandelara, on to talk early in the playoffs.
Yeah, DA was on to kind of kick off Super Wild Card Weekend. Not sure what we're doing guest route yet. Don't want to tease anything. May just go solo and just break it down X's and O's by myself. But we will be efforting to get someone on the pod this week.
Yeah, efforting is always important on these things. Joe, thanks for all the time. I really appreciate it.
Mike, anytime.
Yeah, up next, I'm going to do the 2-minute drill. I'm going to talk about what the Yankees do in the rotation and give the Mets some props doing the right thing PR-wise with the Jarrett Porter mess right after this.